G'day. So what does it mean to engage in successful flailing? Well, sometimes you're given a problem and you kind of know what it's about. It might be about right triangles or repeating decimals or something. But you really don't have any idea how to actually answer the question at hand. So what do? You engage in successful flailing. That is, you list everything you know that could be related to the question and hope for the best that things will fall into place and make some sense. So if the question is indeed about right triangles, just list everything you know about right triangles. If it's about repeating decimals, list everything you know about repeating decimals, and so on. Maybe you can draw a picture, just do something related to the problem. So to illustrate this very quickly, here's a question. 9 students sit in a circle and have the remarkable property that the age of each student equals the average of the ages of his or her 2 immediate neighbors. And in this question, I'll tell you Betty is 10. And I'm going to ask, how old is Lucas, also sitting in the circle? All right. So, I look at this question, I have an emotional reaction, I don't know what to do. But I do know it's about averages, and I know stuff about averages. What does average mean? It means, I guess you're in the middle of the two neighbours. So for example, now I don't really know what Betty's neighbours' ages are, but suppose this neighbour is 13 years old, as in 3 up from 10, I know that her neighbour on the other side must be 3 down from 10, 7 years old. Okay, probably wrong, I'm just flailing, that's okay. But look at this person, 13. Betty is 3 years down, so in order for 13 to be the average of his 2 neighbours, this person better be 3 up, 16. This person better be up 3 up, 19. So on and so on and so on. Just playing, but look what happens. 3 up, 3 up, 3 up, 3 up, 3 up, and then suddenly I have to keep going up by 3s, and I have to come back down to 7, 10. Ha! I can see this sort of situation can't happen. The only way out of the situation is if, in fact, each person doesn't go up in age at all. In fact, everyone in the circle, for this probably to work, must be 10 years old. Bingo. My flailing has worked. Lucas, no matter where he is in the circle, must also be 10 years old. The power of engaging in successful flailing. Super. Thanks for watching. For more curriculum inspirations material, go to our website. Lots of great stuff there.